This is Paul Rogers reporting from the city of Hawthorne. We're in front of the former home of the Wilson family, which was torn down years ago to make way for the 105 freeway. But now there is a beautiful monument that pays tribute to their legacy and to Hawthorne. Hey, what's up, Hawthorne? Well, what's up is that we're gonna go on that Hawthorne Beach Boys tour that we did a couple years ago. We're gonna take it over again, and we're gonna, you know, some exciting things, new footage, interview with Dave Marks, interview with Harry Jannigan, who's trying to put a historical marker right over here. So this is gonna be some, I got some other new footage. I got a new concert footage from El Camino College, so stay tuned, Hawthorne. Well, before I start the show, I thought I'd bring you up here to the city of LA. We're at 8012 Harvard Street, and this house is where Murray and Audrey Wilson lived in 1942 to 1945, and where Brian and Dennis were both born. Then Carl was later born in Hawthorne, of course. So let's get on with the show.
I got up this morning, turned on my radio. I was checking out the surfing scene to see if I would go. And when the DJ tells me that the surfing is fine, that's when I know my baby and I will have a good time.
Hawthorne. Well, what's up is that we're here at Best Buy to check out the new album by, well, I'll tell you, it's not the Sprung Monkey. It's actually by the Beach Boys. They have a new album called Hawthorne, California, the birthplace of a musical legacy. Their CD celebrates their 40th anniversary in the music business, and it all started right here in Hawthorne. The CD has a lot of studio sessions, rarities, alternate versions, promos, everything you want for the Beach Boy fan. And if you look on the rack here, there's a whole bunch of other Beach Boys. I noticed the famous Pet Sounds CD. This record inspired the Beatles to do Sgt. Pepper's. Of course, the Beach Boys are most known for their surfing sound, Surfing USA and other ones like that. This one here even has a Hawthorne High School logo on their cover, the sign on their cover here. Hey, Louie, where you going? Over here. We gotta go over and try to find the house. 3701 119th Street. Meet me over there, okay?
1, 2, 3, go.
Well, it was here 40 years ago. This was the Brian Wilson house where the Wilsons lived, Brian, Carl, and his brother Dennis. They were the Beach Boys, in case you don't know. And what we're going to do today is take a tour of Hawthorne back in the days of the Beach Boys and find out where they hung out, what they did. Before we do that, we've come back here to the old Wilson home site where they're finally building California Registered Landmark number 1041. Now we're going to talk to the Beach Boy fan who came up with the idea to make this all possible. Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
You wouldn't have to be a Beach Boy fan, would you?
Absolutely. One of the big ones.
What's your name?
My name's Harry Jernigan.
And what exactly are you doing here today?
Well, what we're trying to do is right in this area here is where the Beach Boys home used to be, at the 3701 West 119th Street. And what I'm doing right now is make an application to the state of California to put an historic landmark sign right here. Well, this gentleman here is David Marks. He started out with Beach Boys.
David Marks, one of the original Beach Boys.
Yeah, I was just visiting my old friend Louis Morata down the street here and wondered what was going on around here. So we're going to try to get that monument put up here, that Beach Boy historical landmark.
And so how long have you been a Beach Boy fan?
Oh, I would say since I was about 10 years old. It was right about that time that they came out with Surfin' and Surfin' USA and songs like that. And so I've been a fan almost all my life, but the idea for a landmark, it just occurred to me one day. I had read a book about the Beach Boys, and it just occurred to me that they have played a major part in California music history, and it's just too bad there's not a sign here to commemorate some of their early work. And so I thought this would be the perfect place for it.
Great. David, I know I've seen some old pictures of you with the Beach Boys. How long were you a Beach Boy? And
I used to live right here on the corner, right across the street from the Wilsons. I moved in when I was 7, so I naturally became one of the Wilson brothers since I was an only child. I spent all my time at their house and naturally evolved into the band. Brian put the band together, and I was playing the guitar with Carl Wilson, and naturally evolved into the Beach Boys. Yeah, we toured around the country, went to Hawaii a couple times, and in 1965 I quit to pursue my education in my own band, and at the first release, Surf and Safari, I was 14, and I was in the band for about 2.5 years, so I guess I was around 16 or so when I was out of the band for good. And all of a sudden you had a hit record. It was fantastic. It was the best time of my life. 1997, I went back with the Beach Boys and played with the band for about 3 years up until the year 2000. Oh yeah, I have a new CD coming out. It's called Something Funny Going On, and will be out on my website, which is davidleemarks.com, and it'll be available there first of all. I'm really proud of my association with the Beach Boys and Brian Wilson, and like I said, it was one of the best times in my life. No regrets, definitely not. Mm-hmm.
I'm just happy to be able to help this project along in my own way. I'm glad that David came by. This is an incredible opportunity to meet one of the original Beach Boys, and he's part of music history as being part of the Beach Boys. Yeah.
What's your favorite Beach Boys song?
That would be very hard to answer, because a lot of them are my favorites. But I'll have to say that in the top two would be Wouldn't It Be Nice and probably Little Deuce Coupe. No, actually I can't. I'm an engineer, I'm not a musician.
Liverpool, England, Hibbing, Minnesota, Port Arthur, Texas, Asbury Park, New Jersey, and of course Hawthorne, California. What do all these towns have in common? Well, they're all home to legendary rock stars like Bob Dylan, The Beatles, Bruce Springsteen, Janis Joplin. And right here in Hawthorne is where the Beach Boys grew up. And we're going to talk to someone who, rather than become a legendary rock star, he stayed here, became a lawyer, and is now on the city council. He's City Councilman Steve Anderson. Good morning, Steve.
Good morning.
I understand you were friends with Brian Wilson.
Yes, for a long time. Well, this is where the house was, and this is where some of the first records were created. I remember coming over here many, many times when I was in high school and junior high. Played baseball on the varsity for 2 years, and I think he loved baseball more than football, and he was a real sports nut. We also coached in the recreation league here in Hawthorne. Coached a team called the Pirates back in 1960 and 61, and Brian loved kids, loved baseball. His career just kind of happened. His dad had a short musical career himself, and Brian was, of course, he was Brian. And his brother Dennis was a drummer. Carl was a guitar player. And cousin Mike Love was a singer. And Al Jardine was a member of the Beach Boys, was also a member of our football team. Brian was just very happy to be able to make money singing and performing. Loved music, loved to write, loved to produce. Producing was his number one thrill. great sense of humor, wonderful sense of humor. A good guy and a good friend. Always been a good friend. Never got stuck up or in love with himself or anything like that. Always a good guy. It's hard to summarize a 40-year friendship, a 45-year friendship. We first met in 1955. We've been friends ever since.
Well, this is where it all really started for the Beach Boys, right here on the campus of Hawthorne High. Their first records were teenage stuff like Cars, Girls, and of course Surfing. And of course they were great records back then. Number one hits started coming out. And after they were famous even, 1969, they came back and played the prom here. And in 1989, Brian Wilson was Grand Marshal for the Hawthorne Parade. And also that year, Tom Quintana of HCTV's Hawthorne Today interviewed Brian and asked him if he ever thought when he was a kid that he would be famous as he was.
Well, not really, no. How could I have, you know? I mean, there would be no way that I could have, but it's sure nice to go back and reminisce, you know? My father was a little bit rough on me, sure. But my friends helped me through high school, you know, so I'm sure that made a difference.
Beach Boys have always had the image of fun, sun, and surf. Let's hear what Brian had to say about the Beach Boys' image.
We did our songs, and people thus made our image for us. They fed us back with what they thought our image was. It's a funny thing. We kind of would make the music, and then the journalists all around the country would then thus, over the years, slowly shaped and molded our image, which was California, sunshine, and girls, and the seashore, and the sand, you know?
Brian then shared his thoughts on success.
If it comes fast, sometimes it can throw you for a loop, you know, and it confuses you. You know, you got to keep that bigger picture in mind as to what you're doing and know a little about everything, just a little about everything, in order to know what direction to go in.
Oh, hey, there you are. We're standing here in front of the Hawthorne High School sign. Now, this sign is not the same sign that was on their album cover. It was donated to the school by the class of 1968. At one time, the Beach Boys were just as big a group as the Beatles. Now we have a clip from the VH1 special, The History of Rock and Roll, and let's ask Brian if he was jealous at all of the Beatles' success.
When we saw what happened with the Beatles, we got together and had a meeting and said, look, now what are we gonna do here? We're getting eclipsed by a group called the Beatles from London. Oh my God, we were completely jealous as hell. I guess I'm gonna turn our motors on. I think it's something happening where we would be better musically than the Beatles.
We always pick my car because it's never been beat, and we've never missed yet with the girls we meet. None of the guys go steady because it wouldn't be right to leave the best girl home now on Saturday night. I get around, I get around, I get around, I get around, I get around.
Well, when some loud bragger tries to put us down, I say, what's the matter, buddy? Ain't you heard of our school? We're number one in the state. Well, Brian Wilson and Al Jardine played football right here on Halcap Field when they were number one in the state.
Brian Wilson and I were classmates right here at Hawthorne High School. I knew the whole Wilson family, Murray, Audrey, Dennis, Carl, and their cousin Mike Love. Their place was like a second home to me, and they were always singing together. Always singing harmonies. They love to do that, especially Brian. At Hawthorne, we were on the football team together. We played in the backfield, and I remember once we were in a huddle, and the cheerleaders were singing the Hawthorne fight song. And right in the middle of the huddle, Brian starts singing the melody. Onward, Cougars, onward.